destination.
Bodyguard than an assassin.
Stabilizing.
Is that your primary function?
Confirmation. It is a very difficult task indeed that I have kept Masters Benico and Vortena alive. Despite their high-risk activities, is my greatest achievement.
The two of them seem close.
Deflection. I am not programmed to assess or discuss the emotional matters of meatbags under my protection.
Thank you.
systems online. Stamina increased. Admiration. It is a great pleasure to witness your skills firsthand, Master.
Master?
Clarification. Master Benico altered my programming before we secured your release. I am to serve you with the same unexcelled loyalty with which I serve her. In fact, your survival is now my highest priority.
I'm no more important than Lana or Koth. Don't prioritize me above them.
Concession. I will alter my prioritization as you request, Master. Gossip. You are just as selfless as I had been led to believe. Resumption. Shall we continue?
Is this the object you picked up on your sensors?
Confirmation. Yes, Master. A closer scan suggests that this object has been here for several centuries.
Centuries? Of all the junk out here, you had to find the antique.
Observation. Visible design elements do not match any from Zakulan culture, antique or modern.
Not from Zakul. Could it be?
He doesn't overthink things.
Ha ha!
Do you have any idea what this is?
It looks like some kind of old spacecraft.
This is the Gravestone. This was the only ship that ever went up against the Eternal Fleet and won. Do you have any idea how long people have been looking for this thing?
And we just happened to stumble upon it.
You said this ship went up against the Eternal Fleet and won. But it's rusting in a swamp while the fleet is still around.
The fleet is even older than Valkyrie, maybe even older than Zakuul. The battles happened centuries ago. Nobody knows the details of the whole war, but every story talks about the Gravestone. One ship with the firepower to take on the Eternal Fleet. This is fate. We get your Outlander. Find exactly the weapon we need. We're going to win this thing, Mana. It's destiny.
It's certainly no coincidence, but destiny? I think there's something else going on here.
The will of the Force guides us all, if we learn to listen.
Rely on your Jedi ideals if you wish, but there's more to this, I'm sure of it.
Let's have a look inside, huh?
Assessment. Nearby signs of animal activity suggest local predators may be using this wreck as a nesting ground. Caution is advised.
We'll split up, deal with any wildlife, then regroup to plan our next move.
Thank you.
all set. Heal up.
And if they didn't make a safe landing?
We'll know soon enough. Skytroopers, sweep the area. Focus on regions with high metallic sensor readings.
I oversaw security in the Carbonite prison. I humbly submit myself to answer for this failure.
Sister.
I didn't like his answer.
So this ship has been here for, what, 1,000 years? More?
Right. It's amazing that it's in such good condition, considering. Judging by the damage I've seen, the stories are true. Whoever built the gravestone scuttled it themselves after the Eternal Fleet was defeated. It wasn't shot down.
The fleet was defeated, but not destroyed. Valkorion brought it back under his own control more than a century ago.
Exactly. The Eternal Fleet is totally automated. Nobody knows who first built it, and every theory is crazier than the last.
Renegades left behind after a successful droid revolution. Representatives of an entire race of droids from somewhere beyond the edge of the known galaxy.
Like I said, crazy stuff. But no matter where it came from, the Eternal Fleet is practically unstoppable. And Arkhan controls every single ship from the throne.
If Valkorion has had this unstoppable fleet for more than a century, why didn't he use it to help the Sith Empire defeat the Republic?
We can only theorize. If the war was just part of a ritual to make the Emperor truly immortal, perhaps using the fleet would have interfered somehow. Regardless, we have many other things to discuss. I owe you 5 years' worth of explanations.
And I'm gonna need some parts to get this thing moving again.
Locating supplies and fresh water would also be wise.
Let's get those parts first. Might take a while to install them.
Yeah. Ship this old? There's no telling.
Assertion. I will begin a patrol pattern to ensure that no enemy forces report our position.
Yula. Heal up. Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet. hard to stop thinking about Denon sometimes, you know? It's Destiny. I ditch all these parts before we crash, we find the gravestone, and then what do we need to get it flying? Honestly, it's plain as day. Not for Lana, though. For her, it's all just skill and luck and coincidence.
I'm with you. Things always end up going my way. There's really no other explanation.
Let's hope that includes taking down Arkin. Lana's told me about all the things you've done. More than once. Half the reason I agreed to this crazy rescue was to see if you were actually real. So, I figure I know all about your past. You deserve to know mine. I grew up on Zakuul. Served in the military. I captained a warship during Arkin's campaign against the Core Worlds. One of the last ships without an all-droid crew. My crew and I deserted, but I'm not going to pretend we didn't do our share of damage beforehand. Just thought you should hear it from me.
Something must have happened to make you desert your post. What was it?
We were holding territory on Denon. Locals rioted and orders were to open fire until they stopped. None of us even wanted to be there. Massacring civilians? That's not how Zakuul is supposed to operate.
Thank you for being honest with me. You and your crew made the right choice.
Glad you think so. One more thing, as long as we're being honest. When you risked your life to shut that generator down, you showed me that you're someone I can count on. I want to take Arkin down, but we don't have to take down all of Zakuul with him. I'm glad to know you understand that too.
Too many innocent people have suffered already. I'm not going to add to that.
Thank you. Come on. Let's get this stuff back to the gravestone.
Salutation. It is a pleasure to see you again so soon, Masters. I've encountered minimal resistance in my patrol.
Minimal?
Reassurance. Only one skytrooper and three local predators with poor survival instincts. Our position appears to be secure at this time, but I would still advise caution on your return trip, Masters.
Keep up the good work, HK.
Appreciation. It will be my pleasure to do so, Master.
Welcome back. Did you find what you were looking for?
More or less. I'll see what I can do.
Shall we, then? We won't last long without more food and water.
Let's go.
Should feel better now. Got you.
when Darth Maar and I faced Valkorion, we knew right away. He was the Sith Emperor, Lana.
I know. When he was struck down, it released ripples through the Force. Everyone who had felt the Sith Emperor's presence in the past, on Zyost, on Yavin 4, we all sensed what had happened. Arkhan invaded soon after, claiming that an Outlander had assassinated his father, the Immortal Emperor. It didn't take long for us to unravel the truth.
Which side did Arkhan attack first?
Both. Ships from the Eternal Fleet struck at shipyards and rallying points for both sides simultaneously. They favored ambush tactics throughout the war. Zekulan's sensor technology has far greater range than our own, and their ships can fly much further on less resources. Only vessels retrofitted with Isotope 5 could manage to outrun them. None could truly compete.
Managed to hold out.
Within 3 months, the bulk of our naval forces were disabled or eliminated, and the Republic was in the same situation. With naval superiority, Arkhan's forces could begin choking off supply lines, trade, any ship travel at all. The Eternal Fleet seemed to be everywhere at once. Coruscant and Dromund Kaas were blockaded by the end of the first year. The members of the Dark Council fought Arkhan's invasion ruthlessly and lost. The Empire's treaty was ultimately negotiated by the Minister of Logistics. Chancellor Suresh also refused to discuss surrender, but the Republic Senate managed to overrule her. A cadre of senators negotiated their own ceasefire terms. All of those senators have since been disgraced or dismissed. I'm sure you can imagine the likely culprit.
What about the Jedi Order?
I know that they suffered heavy losses, but that's the extent of my information. I've sent agents to find out more, but none have returned. I wish I had more to tell you. So far, the treaties with Zekul have held. But that will not last forever.
Thank you.
Shall we? I've got you. A freshwater spring. It should be safe for drinking.
So the Eternal Fleet overwhelmed both the Republic and the Empire. What was the result?
Both sides are forced to pay a heavy tribute to Zakuul, mainly raw materials and resources. They're also held under an arms limitation statute. The Empire and the Republic are both breaking it, of course, but they're still incapable of challenging the throne directly.
Who's in charge of the Republic now?
Suresh reached the end of her term limits recently, but her replacement is a carefully selected puppet. She still runs things, even if she isn't officially the Chancellor anymore.
And the Empire?
Only one member of the Dark Council remained after the chaos. Darth Asena. She now rules as Empress of the Sith. Both sides see this only as an opportunity to eliminate one another at a time of weakness, instead of combining what strength they have. Arkhan does nothing to prevent violence between them, so long as their tribute is paid and no one challenges Zakuul's superiority.
I'm surprised Arkhan didn't try to destroy both governments. He obviously had the firepower.
I don't think Arkhan feels any desire to actually govern our portion of the galaxy. For now, he sees it as a backwater, useful only for resources. Powerful Zakuulan battle stations have been placed in orbit around key worlds to watch for possible uprisings. But there are no ongoing planetary occupations. The ships of the Eternal Fleet simply patrol at random, while the tribute paid to Zakuul gradually chokes all economic potential.
What about my team? My ship?
I have allies looking for them as we speak. With all of the chaos of the last few years, though, it will take time to find them all. For now, we make do with ourselves, Koth, and HK.
You obviously put a lot of thought into getting me out. Did you think about what would come after?
Of course, though I admittedly didn't plan on being stranded in this swamp. For now, let's take things one step at a time.
So why me? You clearly went to a lot of trouble to get me out of Carbonite.
Before you were captured, you accomplished things no one else dared to attempt. You changed the galaxy more than once, and if things have ever needed to change, now is the time. But there is something else. I felt it since the moment I found you in Carbonite. There's a power in you. Something new. It's elusive, but I know it's there.
I think you're right, Lana. I think the Emperor, Valkorion, is in my mind.
What?
After he died, there was a storm of energy. I barely even remember being thrown into the carbon freezing chamber. And then, while I was frozen, I saw things. Dreamed about him, about everything that happened while I was gone.
It can't be. If he were controlling you, I'd know it. I certainly saw enough of it on Xyost.
I don't think he's trying to control me, not directly anyway. He was trying to convince me to work with him.
Whatever he's doing, we can be sure that he's always trying to deceive us somehow. I believe in you. And I appreciate your honesty. I'll remain watchful for any influence he might have over you. For the time being, though, we have no choice but to proceed.
What about the others?
They wouldn't understand. And like you said, we really don't know anything for sure yet. Let's keep the matter between us for now.
Request. Please rendezvous at my current coordinates at your earliest convenience, Masters. I require assistance.
Strange. We should hurry. This will help.
Save us!
HK, explain.
Protestation. I have done nothing to these pitiable meatbags, Master. They were merely bystanders when I destroyed a group of Sky Troopers. They've requested our help in escaping the enemy's notice.
Please, we are no danger to you. We were exiled for protesting Emperor Arkhan's war. We've already lost two of our friends. Please, is there anything you can do for us?
We're repairing a ship with room for passengers. We can get you out of here.
You're serious? That's incredible. Thank you. Thank you so much.
The path ahead of us is not a safe one. They might be better off here.
No one could be better off here. Sure, we can make it fly again.
She'll fly. Just been waiting for somebody to come along and remind her how.
Let's get to work then.
We'll be right back. I take it you have questions. Don't be so surprised. Where you go, I go. We are indivisible now. The gravestone. Not entirely what I'd envisioned.
I thought you were just a dream.
I assure you, I am real. As is my intent to see you flourish. You have had a taste of my son's empire, his reach, and Valen. She does not believe in respect. We can only defeat Arkhan if we work together.
I don't buy for one moment that you're on my side.
Were the roles reversed, perhaps I would be skeptical as well. But what if I could prove my sincerity? Would you continue to see me as your eternal nemesis? Or would you open your eyes to the truth?
Get ready for a fight, people! They found us! Sky Troopers breaching the entrance!
That's just the first wave. They have more on the way.
I'll head them off.
The gravestone will be ready soon. I just need...
Don't say 3 minutes.
Buy me some time. I'll get us airborne.
I'm with you. HK, stay behind and help Koth.
Until I say so, don't touch anything.
Should feel better now.
Let's go.
Here, this will help.
Will help.
say there were more on the way.
Something I've learned to count on regarding Arkhan. There will always be more.
Too many!
We have to keep fighting.
Hey, you two need a hand out there?
No. We have help.
You what?
You're late.
You got one of the knights to switch sides?
Not all of us blindly follow Arkhan.
More resistance, knights.
High Justice, we have the Outlander.
I do hope you're up to fighting your own, Senya.
My issue isn't with them. But if they're going to stand in my way...
I see you found another pragmatist.
Stow the chatter. Prove you can fight.
Thank you. pathetic. This will be avenged. Will be avenged. The Emperor will be avenged! I need help! Be avenged!
Save yourself!
What is this?
An opportunity. You are outmatched. Death is all but certain for your Sith friend. I could save her. I only require the briefest moment of control. Accept my help. Or watch her die. Choose quickly. Time has not stopped.
I'll never give in to you.
Very well.
You can do this! Keep fighting! They haven't killed you yet. Come on!
Koth, thank you.
Is the gravestone ready for takeoff?
Far as I can tell. Looks like we've got everyone. Let's go!
No, wait. Where's Senya?
Excuse me? Where's who?
Here I am. Let's move out.
Whoa, wait a minute. Hang on. She's your help? If you think I'm letting that piece of work on my ship, you're out of here.
Interjection. Many more hostiles are approaching. Permission to defend with extreme prejudice.
No more fighting. We must leave Zakuul.
I'll prep the engines. Come on, Lana.
No. I'm needed out here. I'll be fine.
Be ready to move.
The ship will never pull itself up from the muck. We'll have to give it a push.
Firing up the engines.
I hope.
We can do this.
Concentrate. Feel the force as it ripples through you.
Actually doing it. Can you believe it?
Observation. The ship is rising. Conclusion. Belief is not required.
Glad you worked that out.
Get in here so we can finally get moving.
My gravestone can move.
Considering how we found it, I'd say you've outdone yourself.
Team effort. I'd say everyone outdid themselves. Incoming! Dropping out of hyperspace! It's a lot!
The Eternal Fleet.
They aren't firing.
Okay, ship. What are you waiting for?
HK, see about that hyperdrive. Lana, work the shields. And we need a gunner.
I'll take care of it.
Capital ship near the center.
I see it.
Good. Now hit it.
Can't keep up. It's real. We could take the whole fleet.
Statement. The hyperdrive now meets minimum functionality requirements.
Why didn't you say so? All right, let's get out of here.
More than 2 dozen ships lost. A single shot.
So that's the gravestone. It's as powerful as they say.
Everything stands at risk. Sakul, the throne, my vision for the galaxy. All because we let the Outlander slip away. I'm not blaming you.
I didn't think you were.
Father held us all back. You more than any. Such raw power, and yet you're still spreading your wings, finding your limits.
Nice to be appreciated for a change. So, what now?
Now, I act.
What's happened?
The hyperdrive worked. One time. Omnicannon's fried too. What a mess.
We're safely away from the fleet, if nothing else.
Should be able to make it to Asylum, but let's not hold our breath.
What is this Asylum place, and why are we going there?
Asylum is a skyport. A safe haven from Arkan's patrols.
Was she really necessary?
She helped us raise the gravestone. She fought at our side.
She also hunted me like an animal for years. She was Arkan's loyal knight.
I thought I was in service to Zakul. You had abandoned your responsibilities.
It sounds like you're both on the same side now. Whatever history you have, it's best to let it go.
You don't know what she's capable of. You weren't there.
Do they know what you're capable of, Vortena? If anybody needs me, I'll be somewhere.
You could have at least consulted with me first.
Yes, I wonder how that might have gone.
Absolutely! I'd be glad to fix the gravestone by myself. Can't there be a maintenance manual? Hey, can you get the power? Right over there. Thanks. Wouldn't want to electrocute myself on top of everything else. She's really something, this ship. But no one's been taking care of her.
You've grown attached rather quickly.
No offense, but it's the gravestone to save the galaxy from Arkan. Not you. Me, definitely not Senya.
Lana believes she can help us. That's enough for me.
Hey, I trust Lana. I think the world...
Look, I'm just saying she might not know Senya as well as she thinks. Senya acts according to, I don't know what, her own narrow concept of justice, maybe. Even if her objectives align with yours, it doesn't mean she'll do what you need to get done. Believe me, just don't forget who dropped everything to storm the spire and help Lana pull you out of Carbonite, all right?
I'd be a frozen carcass if you hadn't.
I have a good feeling, you know. We'll get Arkin. I should get back to it. Need to be sure the gravestone can get us all the way to Asylum. Hey, maybe you should check in on Lana, see how that wound's doing.
You should have someone look at that.
I'll heal. I was right to reach out to Senya. I hope you see that.
She's a good fighter. She helped us raise the gravestone. I'd say she's an asset.
And she doesn't give up either. That was clear the first time I encountered her. We met shortly after I arrived in Wild Space. Senya was hunting Koth. I was hoping to learn your fate. We exchanged what information we could. This was all before I really knew Koth, of course. Years ago.
Those two will have to get past their differences.
It won't be easy. I suppose I should get back to healing. And you should get to know Senya. I'm not sure if you'll hit it off exactly, but I think you'll find her intriguing.
Dropping?
Correction. I was monitoring activity in order to ensure everyone's safety, Master. Report. I have taken the liberty of checking in on your band of refugees. Assessment. They have quickly taken to their new lodging arrangements. I have warned them not to stray from their chosen location. Analysis. There are many sealed passageways, and I am unable to detect what may be on the other side.
Worth looking into at some point?
Revelation. I discovered an especially strange area. Unlike anywhere else on the gravestone, I had attempted to ascertain if any of its contents could be weaponized, but the new meatbag interrupted. Query. Any orders, Master?
As you were, HK.
Approval. I like your orders.
I couldn't help but take this place in either. Reminds me of a song I wrote.
I'd like to hear that. Just a few bars.
Without accompaniment? I'm not that brave.
You seem nothing at all like the person I met in the swamp.
Being a knight means everything. But I don't let it define me. When it's time to go to work, I'm who I need to be. The rest of the time, I'm just myself. You don't strike me as all that different.
I live by a code, but I don't follow it to the letter.
Your Jedi code? I've heard it recited. It's interesting. Wouldn't work for me, I don't think. Definitely wouldn't work for Arkin.
I know why I oppose him. What's your reason?
Years after the death of our immortal Emperor, most are still so afflicted with remorse that they don't see what's happening. Arkin has become oppressive and cruel. He'll crush anyone who doesn't share his plan for the galaxy. So that's me. What about you?
Arkin wants to lay waste to everything I've fought for and accomplished. I won't let him.
Neither will I. I may not know much of the worlds you've inhabited, but I do know what he's doing to them. You're not what I expected. Not sure if that's good or bad yet. But I do know I'll have an easier time with you than Koth.
I hope you'll try to get along. The more we work together, the better off we'll be.
Just because he betrayed our enemy doesn't change the fact that he was a traitor. You need to be cautious.
Valkorion lives. He is not himself, nor has he taken a new body. It is difficult to see, and yet it is unmistakable.
His presence in the Force has always been deceptive.
Like on the Yavin Moon.
Yes, and many times before and since. Even when my life depended on it, I did not see him properly until it was too late.
Approaching Asylum.
Told you we'd make it.
We haven't docked yet.
I should probably figure out how to land this thing.
You're sure that place is safe?
We need allies as much as safety. That shadow port isn't on any chart. It's a haven for refugees fleeing Arkin's forces.
We'll be among friends. Mostly.
Tell your associates we've arrived.
They knew that days ago.
You want to explain how? Figures.
If we don't all start trusting each other, we're doomed.
Trust is a rare commodity these days.
Command, are we there yet?
way, Gawkers.
Let us through.
Mighty fine ship you got there. We'll be coming aboard.
If there's one thing I don't like, it's uninvited guests.
Ha! Captain!
Outlander, my crew. The best engine burners in wild space.
You could have introduced them sooner.
This was more fun. Get up here, you mangy woolocks.
Do I know you?
Name's Rollo. I served aboard Darth Maar's destroyer. We thought you died with him.
I may as well have.
Without you, none of us would have gotten off that ship. Never thought I'd get to say thanks.
Glad you made it out. Nice to see a familiar face.
I imagine this is all pretty weird for you.
Rilo! Get in here!
On my way!
I'm not the only one hiding things.
We share on a need-to-know basis. Koth's crew didn't need knowing.
Do you trust them?
Yes. I wish they bathed more often, but you get used to it. I need to make contact with my network alone. Try to stay out of trouble.
Where's Lana?
Excellent question.
My best engineer hasn't come back from a supply run to the Free Zone. It's a dodgy neighborhood, if you catch my drift.
A black market. Rival syndicates disagree over who controls it.
They argue with blasters. I think she's in trouble, but we've got our hands full keeping the Gravestone's reactor stable.
Give me a holo of your crewmate and point me to this Free Zone. I'll handle the rest.
Addendum. I will join you, Master.
My engineer's name is Tora. HK has her image in its databanks.
She won't be hard to find. Tora has a big personality.
She's surlier than a hungry Rancor, but she's the best engineer you'll ever meet. Thanks for the help.
And when you're done, find me these coordinates. I'll introduce you to my people.
Help me find Koth's engineer and we can go together.
I'll join you, but not now.
You are much improved.